Presented by Church Tech U, it's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, a ProPresenter hack, how to fill text with video in ProPresenter 7. Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I help you learn all about ProPresenter. My name's Paul Allen Clifford. And before we get started, if you've been wondering if this is possible, go ahead and subscribe to this channel. Click the little bell icon and give me a thumbs up while you're at it. So, credit where credit is due. I did not come up with this hack. This is something that Jonathan Gale over in the ProPresenter users community came up with. Now, I started the community, but he was the one that did the work on this, and I think it's brilliant. Now, granted, let me just tell you, this is convoluted. Let me also tell you that this is something that Renewed Vision might make obsolete in the future, just by making it easier to do. Also, if you don't have a powerful enough computer, this might not work for you. So with all of those things stated, let's head over to the computer and I'll tell you exactly how to do this. So here we are in ProPresenter 7. And the first thing we need to do is we need to have an output that sends video out of ProPresenter. This is going to make sense, I swear to you. So let's go over into screens and then configure screens. I've already added one, but if we go to live stream right here, I added this at 1280 by 720. And since I'm on a Mac, it's a little, at least it seems to me, a little less heavy lifting to use Siphon to do this, but you could also use NDI in order to send it out of ProPresenter. So that's thing number one. Add a screen that its only job is to send video out of ProPresenter as Siphon or NDI. If you're on Windows, NDI is your only choice as I'm recording this, but that's what I would do. Okay, that's step number one. Step number two is we need to bring that video back into ProPresenter. This is going to make sense, I swear. Bring this back into ProPresenter. So in order to do that, let's go to ProPresenter and then Preferences, and let's go to Inputs. And I have already added it here. I didn't change the name, so yep, here we are. I basically just clicked on the plus button up here and added it, and noticed that I have the device as Siphon 1. I could also just as easily make that an NDI device. So I'm bringing that in. Let me actually click on something else and then back on it so that it's clear. Okay, see how that's one of the things with it. If you're using Siphon, you might need to go back in here before service and redo this. So that's showing right there. So that's good. And that's got a pink background because I'm using, if we go back into screens and then configure screens, this live stream, I've got the screen color selected. You don't have to have that selected, but just to make this easy to tell that something is in fact going on, that's what I'm going to do. Okay? So now, what I need to do is make sure that text is routed to that output. So I'm going to click on this, and let's go to... hide myself for just a second, my live stream output, and notice that we do have text routed there, so that's good. I'm actually, if I go into edit looks. I'm going to turn off some of the other things here. So let's turn off props and turn off messages here so that it's only the slide that's going out of the live stream. And let's turn off slides in my main output. I'll show you why, but do leave on props and media here in here as well. We can disable video input, but I definitely need media and props to show up here. Okay. Now I'm going to go ahead and click save just so that I'm sure that that works. Okay. So now if I go to, let's go to my main output, nothing showing up right here. That's because I need a prop. I could also do this on a couple of different layers, anything above the slides layer. So if I wasn't using the announcements layer, I could do that. But I'm going to do props because I am using the announcement layer. I'm using that for this guy right here. So just to show you how, going to click on the props icon and let me just add one from scratch. So I'm going to click the little plus button here and let's call this something that makes sense. So live input. Okay. Now let's right click on this and go into edit. And what I need to add here is I need to add, go to video input. Let's make sure that we fill the screen with this. Although you don't necessarily have to, but you'll see why here in just a second. So I fill the screen with this, and where it says video input, let's make sure that it is the input that I selected earlier. Remember, it was, I should have renamed it, but it's the NDI scan converter input. Now here is where the magic happens. I'm going to click on inspector and I'm going to go to effects. Then I'm going to click on this little plus button right here and I'm going to add the color key effect. And when I do that, by default it was set to white. So since I had the white text, it has removed the white text. So now I've got this pink background, I've got this blue bar background. This black here is actually, it's transparent. So if we go back here to show and I click on this and make sure that my live input, yep, there we go. My live input prop has to be on for this to work. Now I can select any video background, and it might be kind of hard to tell here, but the text is filled with that input. So it could be a logo, it could be just a picture, it could be a video, whatever I want, it will fill there. Now, maybe that's too subtle for you, so you would want to use a theme that has larger text. Perfectly good way to do it. But that is how you could do that. Do make sure that you have some sort of contrast between the text and the background so that this shows. Because if I didn't have this pink background, so let me just show you what happens. I go into Configure Screens, if under live stream I turn that off, notice it's a little harder to tell. If I didn't have this blue bar here whatsoever, you couldn't see that I had that. So that would be a bit of a problem. But, and see how it's maybe a little more clear that there is video inside this, because as it moves, you see that the letters change color. So, just something for you to consider as you're adding, using this hack. I admit, if this doesn't work, don't bug the support people in at Renewed Vision and say, well, Paul told me. I'm telling you, ask the questions below the video and I'll try and help you out and we'll see what's going on if it doesn't work for you. But that's how to do that. That's how to add a video fill to text using a hack in ProPresenter 7. If you like this content, you'd like my ProPresenter 7 Quick Start course, so head on over to tdm.fyi/pro7quick. Give me your name and email address, and I'll make a login for you for free where you can take that course at your leisure. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.